This is division practice number two. If you have the companion assignment that goes along with it, make sure you're following along. We'll go through the first three problems together. If you don't have the companion assignment, that's okay too. You'll get three practice problems to work on. So we're going to start with this first problem. Which, if you have the companion assignment, is number one, 767 divided by 59. Now, there's a couple of ways when we're doing division where we have a two-digit or even a three-digit or four-digit divisor. There's a couple of things that we can do. Now, the first thing you can do is, if you are good at estimating, if that's a skill that you have mastered, then that's where this skill can really come in handy, because we can round this 59 to a 60, and then as we are going through the different steps, we can say, okay, how many times does 60 go into whatever we're looking at? And when we do the mental math, if you're doing this mentally, then it's a little easier to say, okay, what's 60 times 3, or 60 times 4, or 60 times 5? Because if we think of, well, what is 6 times 3, or 6 times 4, or 6 times 5, and we just add a 0 onto that product, then that's going to give us the answer. Again, using this method requires that you're able to round well, and that you're able to do some mental math, that you can do 60 times 5 in your head, which is 300. And again, if you know that 6 times 5 is 30, well, since we've got the 60, we're just adding a 0 on the end. All right. So if you have those skills, and you can do those things quickly and well, then multiplying by multi-digit divisors becomes a little bit easier. If that's not a skill that you have mastered yet, that's okay, because there's another strategy that you can use. It's a little bit more time-consuming, but it is worth the effort. What you can do is you can do the multiples of 59 just off to the side. Now, you can go all the way from 59 times 1 all the way down to 59 times 9, but you may not need to. All right, so what you want to do is you'll want to look at, what are we dividing? And we'll start with the 7. We know 59 doesn't go into 7, so we move to the right one place. How many times does 59 go into 76? Well, that one's pretty easy, because we know that it goes in one time. Because if we go up to 59 times 2, we're going to get 118, which is too much. So 59 goes into 76 one time. 1 times 59 is 59. Subtract. This becomes a 6. This becomes a 16. Sorry, that's an itty-bitty 6 there. 16 minus 9 is 7. 6 minus 5 is 1. We pull down our 7. Now again, here's where your mental math can come in handy, because can think of this as 60 and 177. If we're rounding to the tens place, we'll round up to 180. How many times does 60 go into 180? Well, if you can do that mental math, then you'll know what should go here. But if you can't, then we just continue down factoring. So 59 times 3. Now, as I'm doing this, I'm not mentally doing 59 times 3 in my head. All I'm doing is adding 59 to the previous product. So 59 plus 118 is going to give me 59 times 3. All right, so if I do 59 plus 118, then that's going to give me 7, 7, 1. Ooh. Very interesting. So that tells me that I put a 3 up here, because I know that 3 times 59 is 177. Now, in all these practice problems, you will get whole numbers as your answer. There will not be remainders. So that will be a good, easy way to check and make sure that you've gotten the correct answer if we have no remainder. All right, so my answer for number one is 13. And I had to do a little bit over here. I didn't have to go all the way to 9. I had to go up a bit. But if you're not good at rounding and doing that mental math, then this is a good strategy to use. All right, let's go to number 2. All right, so number 2, we are going to do 1,044 divided by 36. Now again, this is where our mental math can come in handy, because 36 rounded to the nearest 10 would give me 40. How many times does 40 go into 10? Well, it can't. So let's go over to the right one more. How many times would 40 go into 104? Well, I could round 104 to 100, and then in my head I'm just thinking, how many times does 40 go into 100? And if I can answer that in my head pretty easily, then I'll know what my next step should be. If I can't, then off to the side, I should start writing my factors for 36. Now, 36 times 3 gives me 108. Well, that's too much. So I'm going to have to go with 36 times 2 gives me 72. So I'm going to have to go with the 2 because 108 is too much. So that's going to get 36 times 2. Since I've already done the work over here, I already know that that's 72. Now I'm going to subtract. 4 minus 2 is 2. 10 minus 7 is 3. Now, I could have gone ahead and borrowed from this 1 and put a 1 here, but really this is 10 minus 7, so I can just put my 3 down there. All right, then I pull my 4 down. And again, this is where the mental math can come in, because now how many times is 36 going to 324? I have no idea, so let me think about that for a second. How many times does 40 go into 320? 40 into 320 is going to be the same answer as 4 into 32, because I can just cut these zeros off. Well, I know that's 8, but this is less than 40. And this is a little bit more than 320. Mr. Beckwith just told me I'm only going to get whole numbers on this. So let me see what 36 times 8 is before I mess up my problem over here and write a bunch of stuff I may have to erase. So 6 times 8 is 48. Carry my 4. Well, that's already not working, because that's a 4, not an 8, so. Alright, let's finish it up and just see. So 8 times 3 gives me 24, plus 4 gives me 28. So it's 288. So 8 wasn't enough. But I now know 36 times 8 is 288. So if I want to figure out 36 times 9, I could multiply over to the side. 36 times 9, or I could just add 36 to 288. Because remember, when I'm multiplying, each time I multiply, I'm just multiplying up by one number. So it's just adding that original number that I'm multiplying. It's just adding that number to whatever the previous product was. Okay? but let's go ahead and do the 36 times 9. And I'm going to go ahead and be bold here and put that 9 up there. So 36 times 9. 9 times 6 gives me 54. Oh, 54. Mr. Beck with 54. Why are you writing a 5? 54. Carry my 5. 9 times 3 is 27. 27 plus 5 is 32. Dun, 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 dun. So 9 times 36 gives me 324. And so I have no remainder. And as I said previously, on these particular problems, there will not be a remainder, which will be a good way to check to make sure you've gotten the correct answer. Okay. All right, let's do our last problem. All right, number 3, we are going to do 1,178 divided by 38. Now, once again, 38, if I round it to the nearest tens, is going to give me 40, so that's a good way to think about what I'm going to do. Okay? So, let's take a look at this. 38 obviously can't go into 1, obviously can't go into 11. So how many times does 38 go into 117? Well, if I think of 38 as 40, and I think of 117 as 120, rounding 117 to the nearest tens place, then this, some of you should be able to figure out pretty easily, but remember, 120 divided by 40 is going to give me the same product as 4 divided, or excuse me, as 12 divided by 4. Because remember, if I've got these zeros over here, when I'm dividing, I can just cut them off, and it'll give me the same answer. All right, so in both cases, my answer is 3. So let's try 3. All right. Now, I'm not going to do 38 times 3 off to the side this time. I'm going to actually do it within the problem. Because as you get good at division, especially using the standard algorithm, you can actually multiply through the actual setup of the problem instead of writing it off to the side. All right, you have to make sure your handwriting is good, but it's possible to do it. So let's do it. All right, so we've got 3 times 8, which gives me 24. Carry my 2. 3 times 3 is 9, plus 2 is 11. So I multiplied 3 by 38. I didn't use this format. I just did it within the problem. And so when I needed to carry, I just carried right over here. Now, I'm going to go ahead and mark that 2 out because I don't want to get confused later. All right, I'm going to leave this off to the side too, just so I have that answer. All right. So 117 minus 114, 7 minus 4 gives me 3. And then obviously 1 minus 1 is 0, and another 1 minus 1 is 0. And then I'm going to bring down my 8. Now, this should be about the easiest thing I have to do today. Because how many times does 38 go into 38? That's right, one time. 1 times 38 gives me 38. 38 minus 38 gives me 0. And so I have no remainder, which on this particular practice assignment tells you you have probably gotten the correct answer. All right, if you end up with a remainder on this set of practice problems, then you have made an error somewhere.